This individual has digital nail debris and fungi. We call these actually diseased digital nails because unless you culture them, they all just have disease in them. This individual is someone that we need to control not only the nail pathology, where she has a disease in the nail, but you have to control the entire environment. So you want to control the shoes, and you want to make sure that you kill any of the disease within the confines of the shoe, within the confines of the bath, so that anything the foot comes in contact with kills the disease that goes into the foot, that goes into the nail, and causes this to multiply. You also need to make sure that the foot is dry and it's not moist, because that makes the multiplication of the bacteria, mold, and fungi more rapid. So by keeping that under control, you can inhibit the growth by using medication on a daily basis. You must trim the nails if you're using something topically to eradicate the nail pathology. So there are a lot of topical medications that are out there that specifically say they treat fungus. But the problem is that most of the people who have this type of nail pathology also have mold, yeast, fungi, or bacteria in the confines of the nail. And unless you have a medication that treats all of them, your recurrence rate is very high, or you won't get rid of the pathology itself. You can use oral medicine for treating the diseased nails as well, but you must culture it, identify it, and make sure that they don't have any liver pathology or anything that could cause any problems medically during the course of the oral treatment. In my treatment of the nail pathology, I use orals with topical medicines because it's much more effective at eradicating the disease. So we check the disease itself. We treat it with a nail formula, which is topical. Hold on one second. Use a nail formula on the nails on a regular basis, daily. And then once a week, you need to take off the top layers of the skin by filing it, if it's possible. The more often that you file it, the more in contact the medicine can become with the disease to thin out and beautify the nails and also eradicate the disease in the nails itself. Of course, it takes the nails 9 months or sometimes longer to grow all the way out from the proximal to distal ends. So you need to use the medication until it's totally eradicated, and then for prevention, so it doesn't recur, you need to use it when you go to the nail parlor or when you change your nail color, or at least once a month. You should just put on a coat after it's eradicated. You must debride the nails thoroughly, and this patient comes in, we debride the nails, and then we use a power file to eradicate the nails and thin them down so the medication is more effective. As far as the hygiene goes, we have her utilizing for wetness in her socks, which you can test with your hand, or in the confines of the shoe when they're wet. You need to once again dry them out with an agent and put on some foot powder. If they have scaling of their foot, like you can sometimes see the scaling nature in their foot, then on a daily basis it's best to use some type of moisturizing agent like our rejuvenation cream. To prevent recurrence along the course of the treatment, we're advocating utilizing our everyday orthotic insole that she's been wearing, that she takes and can wash because they're removable and washable. And then when she's done doing that, she'll put in the hygienic refresher spray, which puts in the antimicrobial bacterial into the shoe. And on a daily basis, spraying it stops that from reoccurrence into the skin, which then goes into the nail, creating a reinfection of the digital nail pathology. And that's the best way to treat this. If the patient is not cleaning their bath area, because that comes in contact with the foot, then you must add a cleanser for a cleansing unit that we have, a Walk Healthy cleanser for the shower and bath, or use Lysol on a regular basis or Comet on a regular basis to make sure all the surfaces that are in contact with the foot are clean. way. I like it. Okay, now film it. Now the nail formula that we use for treatment of people comes in a clear coat that they can use under any existing color. We have it in red, which is OPI red that matches digital nails, which people use that color on their hands or feet. And it's probably one of the most common colors used, so we matched it. But you can use the medication in contact directly with the nail with any medication. Now we already see that this nail has completely eradicated the disease, and these are starting to change for the better on all the digital nails as long as you debride them after you treat them. You cannot expect it to go away with just putting on topical medicine. You have to actively treat the disease and eradicate the thick nail and all the fungi or disease in the nail in order to get rid of it permanently.